What is going on, everybody? Depraved Slash here, and we are back with another music reaction. I'm Depraved.
I'm Hellcat.
And together we are
Hella Depraved.
And excited.
And very excited. I'm very excited.
This is technically her pick, so.
It's Aviva, guys. And she dropped a new one. And we're going to watch it. Because that's what we do when Aviva drops a track.
Damn straight.
Yes. So this came out last night? Night before? I guess the 14th, right? Because we planned on... So we were going to do this the day after, I guess, it came out, technically speaking, the 15th. And it turned out that our overhead light...
Which was my birthday, by the way.
Yeah. Happy birthday, baby. Decided, with help, that it might not work. So we had to wait until we could get a floor lamp in here so you guys could actually see us. And here we are. So I have been delayed, what, 24 hours, 48?
Something like that.
Let's get to it.
Yes. All right. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to react to this as if you guys have already seen it. If you've not seen it, please click the link in the description below. Hop on over, watch the video, leave a like, leave a sub, leave a comment. Let Aviva know we sent you. And then come on back and we say that because we are going to be pausing to talk about the song. We're going to be pausing to talk about the lyrics,
how they affect us, how they don't affect us,
the video. We're going to be talking about, you know, left turn this, right turn that. We just talk, y'all. It's
a breakdown channel.
Than anything.
That's what it's about. Yes. So, yeah.
Okay. We aren't content thieves. There you go.
That's true.
With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to slash it up and break it down. This is Aviva with Cursed, which, by the way, her last one's name was Wicked. This one's Cursed.
Well, it was Queen of the Freaks.
Queen of the Freaks. Wicked was before
Wicked
that.
Was right before that, but she's all of them are labeled.
Are they all like this?
Absolutely amazing things. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
All right. Let's check it out. Have you seen this symbol? This symbol is the mark of the blank. Stay awake. Stay. Violent?
I don't know. I can't read it from
Stay
here.
Stay aware.
Vigilant?
Stay vigilant.
Stay vigilant. Stay something. Okay. All right.
Okay. Not paying attention to the lyrics.
You see the giant bunny?
I want to know why somebody that is this bad at throwing knives is throwing at our girl here.
Right. Agreed, but I think it's probably supposed to be a like backstabbing type. I mean, granted, that's her front, guys. I do get that, but I'm guessing it's more of a...
I'm just saying, somebody's got some bad aim.
I was looking at the white rabbit.
They got some wicked cursed
hiding
aim.
Hiding there.
Oh, there is a white rabbit hiding.
You hadn't even seen
it. I have not seen the rabbit.
You have now seen the rabbit, and you cannot unsee the rabbit.
All right, Melanie Martinez.
All right.
Now. All right, let's get it. Let's back up a little more. It's a rabbit!
Kinda is, isn't it? Alright. Staring through the back streets of my mind. Why you wanna waste my time? Thought that we were hanging out, but now you'll understand. I got as close as I can. Sing.
I don't think I definitely don't think it was intentional. Her core, her bridge there. Mm-hmm. I'm guessing that was the bridge. Actually, sounded a lot like a Melanie Martinez song.
Which one are you?
I'm trying to peg it.
Oh.
Hold on. ABCs.
Okay.
This is, you are, or how does it go?
Now that I've, A, B, C's, right, okay, all right, I can, I've been there, because I mean, I'm an introvert too, so it takes a long time for me to warm up to someone, and then...
Lies. I got proof.
Well, with you, yeah, it was weird, but like, you open up to someone just to have them, I guess, not be the right person, be a backstabber, take advantage of you, like, I, you know?
Right.
Because that's pretty much what that first verse was talking about, like, she... opened up to someone and they brought her down. That's all they did. I don't know about curse though. Like, I really like the chorus and everything. Don't get me wrong, but like,
maybe I should have had you brush my hair.
Maybe I didn't feel cursed so much as like, I mean, I guess it was a curse, but you know.
Well, so when you're cursed, it usually leads to a lot of negative things happening.
Right.
So, I believe that's why she's saying, you have me cursed, because, like, no matter what she does, she's getting nothing but negative situations.
More, right.
From whoever it is that she's singing though. About.
Yeah, the same person. All right. Running goes, I'm running out of time. Feeling freedom slipping from my life. There's a cure they got me begging for.
Just saying, I don't necessarily know if you're cursed or not, because whoever is throwing is not even coming close, and it's probably a good thing.
Awful at this.
Just saying.
But I do get the, like, symbology of...
Right.
And even the fact that she's facing it, because it's obvious in this song, she knows at this point, obviously, that this person is gonna be nothing but trouble.
Right.
So it makes sense that she's... But she said she didn't make a sound, so she's looking for a way out now, and she knows what the cure is. She just, you know, it's getting out, basically.
Right.
And freedom slipping away, and so, and that is how it feels when you're in a abusive, whether it's just mentally and emotionally type relationship, it's, you know.
Right.
Pretty bad.
There's a rabbit in the background.
Correct.
The symbol very much represents...
You can see the tail end of the metal symbol, too.
Right.
Behind her.
Very much represents a rabbit head.
Okay.
Because you got the triangle face with the ears mm-hmm. that come out.
I can see it.
And she is saying a lot of, like, you dragged me down, down, down.
Right. She has the song Rabbit Hole.
If it's referencing being drugged down the rabbit hole.
It's possible.
And she's had to climb her way out.
She uses a lot of references from, well, Wonderland is one of them. So, I mean, the Rabbit Hole song, obviously, she's talking about her demons and everything, but that's the reference. So it's possible. If anybody knows for a fact, like, I love Aviva. I try not to watch her lives and stuff like that because, again, we do reactions, guys. So if I watch that stuff, it's not a reaction. So I am not filled in on a lot of the other stuff. I watch her crafting things because that's not a giveaway.
I was going to say, we've actually popped into a couple of her lives.
Yeah. I try and hit the lives that are more about, like, her craft corner because, again, right. I know that I'm not going to have a spoiler. But she is singing about something that makes sense. Like, it seems like no matter how bad it was when you were in the relationship, because I've been in some shitholes, as soon as you get out is when that person becomes, like, they stop whatever they were doing and just become obsessed. Like, that's when they want all of your attention. Like, all of a sudden it's like, oh, oops.
There's going to be something I want to touch on. I want to hear the rest of this play out because it's going to require me going back and listening to a little bit, re-listening to a couple things. And we'll even do that here so you guys see what I'm talking about. I want to see if it correlates to something.
Okay.
But
I really like the beast, too. That is really cool that they did, like, the live-action ending.
She has at least one live-action video, don't she?
Well, and there's also...
I don't think we've seen one.
Yeah, she was in the Queen of the Freaks, remember?
I don't.
We watched it for Halloween on a live stream, guys. But, yeah, that had her live.
Oh.
All right, give me a second. We can go back and watch it later.
Give me a second. Cursed, 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 got me cursed. You told me, what's the song Rabbit Hole about?
Demons.
What if that's what this is in reference to? I'm not even 100% sure at this point she's talking about anyone specific. Like, it's directed to anyone.
Right.
But what if, like, because she just talked about, they say there's a cure.
But they don't hand it out.
But they don't hand it out. Which, honestly, this could actually even be turned into depression. Like,
that's true. I mean, so I would say...
Or the demons, which would be, it could be a representation of that depression.
Because she's used a singular, like, for the first verse, and then switched to the plural in this one, which was the second verse. And then she has also switched in the chorus from singular to plural. So you could be correct. And, or she could be singing about both.
Right.
Going from a relationship to her thought process. Her demons, that kind of thing.
And the reason I said that is because, so I was listening to, oh, where was it?
See, it's you and then they.
Right.
Yeah.
But they could be the demons as well.
Right. Now, in
her life.
Rabbit Hole and Shudder and, I mean, these are all other tracks of hers. And you've heard Rabbit Hole. Again, it was alive, so it takes away from our concentration with these.
Right.
It's showing somebody else her other demons. Or, you know. So she is singing to somebody about the demons that she has and showing them whether she plays nice with them or not. depends on the song that she's put out. So it could be, though, because she does sing a lot about her demons. And like I said, whether she is playing nice with them that day or not.
Right.
But her viewpoint of being, you know, outsiders and stuff like that, it also could be society. It doesn't have to be like a relationship. That's just what I relate it to.
Right.
So it could be an outside source still. So
I don't know. There's just something to think about. Yeah. Sorry if that irritated people about going back and re-listening to parts. I just had an idea, wanted to rehear some things, and
had a thought.
See if it fit.
That is what our channel's about. So I love hearing her sing like this, because a lot of times, and I'm not saying that she doesn't sing, but a lot of times she does more like kind of the hip-hoppy sounding kind of verse.
Right.
But actually the Cursed and having her do kind of almost scales and stuff with it, I really liked it, so.
But and also, just me personally, I still, to this moment, don't think I've heard something from her I haven't enjoyed.
Oh, yeah. No, I've listened to pretty much everything.
I still think, so far for me, my favorite song of hers is Wicked. It seems to be the one I remember the most. I
Queen of the Freaks, though. Wicked, you're also going to remember more because it was on our Halloween playlist.
Which is why it ranks so high for me.
And so it got played over and over and over in his car. But Queen of the Freaks came out on Halloween or the day before. So I think it came out like just as we were starting our live stream for Halloween. So it was one of the first ones that we did, and it was amazing. And you were like, babe, it's your anthem. And then we didn't add it to our Halloween playlist because Halloween was over.
It didn't stop me from adding things we've done.
I know, but it was live. It was on our live list, so you just didn't read the list and add it.
Anyways, but yeah, very good song. Absolutely enjoyed it.
She's amazing. I don't know what else I can say. Right. I haven't disliked anything by her, even her old stuff, which was not kind of the way that she has rebranded herself. So.
But yeah, I guess that's going to do it. If you guys like the video, slash that like button, subscribe, ring the bell for notifications, comment down below what did you think of Aviva's Cursed. Also comment down below if there's anything else you guys want to see reacted to, check the description below for all the things.
Push our buttons, come join us on our other social media platforms, mostly Twitter, if you want a quicker response.
With that being said, we love you guys. Thank you all for watching. We cannot wait to see you depraved people later.
Bye-bye. Bye.